science department. In this class we are going to discuss about web application design and web engineering process modeling. Okay, in the previous classes I have already said to you about the web application design. What is a web application design? Web application design. Whenever an application is running based upon the internet, we consider particular application as a web application. The difference between the normal application and the web application is, whenever the normal application, like suppose in our mobile phone, we are using so many applications like camera, and without internet itself, without using the mobile data, you are turning it on, you are doing so many actions and so many tasks you are performing by using that particular application. For example, gallery is one application, Torch that is another application. Just like that, in your mobile phone, you are having so many types of applications. But here, the application which is running based upon the internet, we can say that particular application as a web application. Okay? See, let us see in our mobile phone, WhatsApp Messenger, Facebook Messenger, Facebook, Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, all these applications, even though we are having the Google application also. All these applications, without mobile data, we can't access that particular applications. Is it true or no? We can say that particular application as a web application. Okay, in order to develop that particular application, we have already seen that in order to develop a particular software, we are having so many phases, where we are having so many methods to develop a particular software. Waterfall model, spiral model, V model, just like that we have seen in the previous classes. But when it comes to, in order to develop the web application, what is the main thing we need? What are the process we follow? What is the thing we need? Now let us see what are the things that we need in order to develop the web application. See, in order to develop a normal application, what are the phases we are having? Communication phase. Communication planning, modeling, construction, and deployment. See, we have seen these many phases in order to develop a particular software or application. These are the phases that we have followed till now. See, in communication phase, what are the particular person we do? Here, the software developer and the customer, these two people will communicate with each other regarding the what are the requirements that we need to for that particular software to develop. Just like that. Okay? Next one, planning. In that particular phase, see, in order to develop a particular application, what are the processes? For example, take a waterfall model. By using a particular process model, we are developing, let us assume by using a particular software process model, we are developing a particular software. Let us see the waterfall model. In the first phase, what we will do? Requirements, we will gather the requirements, analyzation, coding, design, testing, and deployment. Just like what in the first phase, what in waterfall model, what is the first in first phase? What we will do? You will gather the requirements. First of all, you will gather the requirements. Just like the next analyzing the particular one. First of all, after gathering these requirements, what we will do? You have to take the requirements to develop the particular software. Okay. Here, for that requirements gathering, the software developer and customer, these two people will communicate with each other. Okay? The next one is planning. The second one is they have to plan whenever you have to develop that particular software, at what purpose, at what particular time you have to develop the particular software, they have to plan. Okay? Next one is modeling. Okay? They have to model. See, suppose this is the application. This is the view of the application. Now let us take the example of the Microsoft Word. See, by looking at the view of the Microsoft Word for the particular user is like this. Yes or no? The Microsoft Office window is like this. Here you are having minimize button, here you are having maximize button, and here you are having close button. Here it will, in the title bar it will apply MS Office, it will appear like MS Office like that. Here you are having some file menu like that, and here in this word, here you are having some editor to type the text and edit the text. Yes or no? Just like that, they have designed that particular software. Why this particular software has designed, why this particular Microsoft Word has designed? Just to edit the text and write the text. Yes or no? Just for that purpose only, they have designed that particular software. Is there any need for that particular software? Is there any need for this software further? Is there any internet need for this particular software? I can say no. Why? Because without the use of internet connection also, this application can run. Yes or no? The software can run. For this, for the development of this particular software, we have to model this software. Yes or no? We have to model. This is the model of this particular software. They have, this is the view. For the user's view, it should be appeared like this. We have to design like this. Okay? The next one is construction. For this appearance, you have to do the construction. Construction means, for if you want to build a particular building, you have to do some block of just like that. Just like that also, in order to develop a particular software, they have to, what are the things they want? They want is some programming, some platform to run. They need some programming language to type, to run and to develop the particular application. By using that some programming language, they are developing that particular application. After construction, in this construction phase itself, you are having so many things you have to do. What you have to do, first of all, you have to code that particular product, and after coding itself, you are, for example, to develop this particular application itself, they have to write some thousands of lines of code, and they have to execute that particular code. After testing that particular code, they have to run in a particular platform. After running, suppose this Microsoft Office is running in a particular platform called in Windows operating system, it is running. Okay, we have to install that particular software in that particular operating system, and we have to check whether it is running successfully in this platform or not. After that, we have to deploy to the customer. These are the things that we have done till you know all this process. This is the process to develop the basic application. If it is a web-based application, what are the things that we are going to do? Now let us see. Okay?
Make the design. For this
application by using the another language. Just like this, the process will repeat. The next one is testing and integration phase is done like this. The next one is operating system. Next one is operating the software. This particular software is operating successfully or not, you have to check. This is the main you have to see. This is the web process framework. This is the web process framework. This is the framework for the web process. See, here you also have the same things like communication, planning, modeling, construction, and deployment. Okay, in the waterfall model, spiral model, we are having the same phases, but in these phases, the tasks we are doing is different. Okay, the tasks what we are doing is different. Okay, here the three first phases, communication phase. There also you are having some phase for communication phase. What it is this communication phase? What we are going to do? The first one is formulation. We have to format what things that we are going to do. Next one is negotiation. We have to negotiate whatever the useless things are there. We have to negotiate a particular one. Next one is election. You have to elect that particular requirement. Whatever the requirement that you need, you have to elect that particular requirement. Next one is whether whatever the web based application or normal application, the main thing you need is you have to first, you have to, whenever you are developing a particular application, first of all you have to communicate with the customer. You have to satisfy the customer needs by using the communication itself. You have to reach the requirements. Okay, the software developer has to reach the requirement of the customer. Okay, the customer, the communication with the customer will come to the software developer, and these two people will discuss with each other. After the discussion, these two people will create an analyzation. Okay, the customer will say to this particular developer, I need this type of software. I have to I need with this particular features. Just like this, these requirements will say. After that, by listening all these conditions, the software developer has to negotiate. Negotiate means the software developer has to leave what are the useless requirements in this communication. If he found any useless requirements, he will negotiate that. After that, he will perform the election. Whatever the requirements he need, he will perform that election. Next one is planning. In this planning, see what are the phases we are having. Estimation, risk analysis, scheduling and modeling. Estimation is cost estimation. To develop that particular application, how much cost they need? They have to estimate that particular cost, no? For that, what are the things he needs is, first of all, he has to deploy the application itself. They have gathered the requirements. By that requirements, by taking that requirements itself, they came to know that. Okay, to take these requirements, we need this much power. It will take this much power. Yes or no? For that, he need one platform. He has to buy the particular platform. He has to write some lines of code. For that, he needs some system like that. For that, all this, by taking all these three conditions, they estimate the cost of that particular software. Next one is risk analysis. Here itself, the risk will be analyzed that whether the particular project will be, we have to analyze what are the risks that we are getting here. In this plan itself, we have to analyze that. Before doing itself, we have to analyze first. What are the risks in that? If any risk occur, what at that time, what we have to do itself before we even take it. Okay? The next one is the scheduling. Scheduling means whenever you are going to schedule that particular project, when you are going to start this particular application, the next one is monitor. From beginning itself, they will gather the requirements. No? After the gathering the requirements, from beginning itself, they came to know that, okay, we can at this particular date, we can start. Okay? The next one is modeling. In this, we are having some two phases like analysis phase and design phase. By analyzing, see, I have already design is the major part of the software developing the web application. Why? Because by designing itself, the user can attract to that particular application. So, the particular user who is using that particular software, he can attract by using the, by the design itself, he can attract to that particular software. Designing is the basic thing. Designing is the major thing in developing the web application or the normal application. Next one is coding. If the designing is not good, we can say, okay, we cannot use this particular application. But if it is a design is good, we can easily and if shutter, this appearance is like this. So here it will display some names of the other members, and here each and every person can send the messages and receive the messages by using the internet, by using the mobile data. Each and every person can see here we design. After designing itself, after designing, what we have to do for this particular thing, we have to write the coding. For this one, you have to write the coding, and after that, you have to integrate that particular coding. After that, you have to perform some. After writing the coding itself, see, for example, if you are writing the code for adding two numbers, first of all, what you do in C language? First of all, you have to compile. After that, you run. If it is not having any errors, it can run successfully on that particular platform. But for the simple lines of code, we are testing. But we are for writing the web application, we will write some lines of hundreds of thousands of lines of code. So no, for that we need to test. The testing is must. Okay, for that what we will do, we perform testing. Okay, after completion of this phase, deployment means delivery. Now the particular product is ready to deliver for the customer. These are the different phases involved in the web process framework. Now let us see how the web engineering process is happening. Okay, this is the web engineering process model. Okay, see, in these phases, communication, planning, modeling, construction and deployment. See, in these phases, what are the tasks we are going to perform here? Now let us see. In the planning, we will identify and we are going to monitor that particular software. See, whenever we are going to perform the planning actions, before planning, what we are going to do, we are going to communicate with that particular software. Software developer is going to communicate with that particular customer. He has to format that particular thing, and he has to negotiate, and he has to elect that particular. The next one is after the communication phase, the next one is the planning phase. In this planning phase, that particular software developer has to identify the risks, what are the risks that are involved in that particular software application. In designing that particular application, these are the risks that we are going to identify. He has to estimate that before doing the project, before entering into the project itself, he has to estimate the risk, and he has to allocate the requirements for that risk also. Why? Because to solve that risk, he needs a particular requirement to solve that risk. Before constructing itself, he has to identify that risk, and he has to take the requirement for that risk also. Okay. The next one is scheduling. After the scheduling, he has to monitor. Scheduling means in particular time, you have to schedule this particular project, just like that, he has to schedule. The next one is monitoring. In this monitoring, they have to monitor the overall entire project, and at next, he has to proceed to the next modeling. In this modeling, he has to analyze that particular product, and next, he has to come to the design. In this analyzation, he has to perform the interaction with the particular software product. But the software developer has to interact with the particular user, whether what type of requirement, what type of designing he has to give. With some type of colors, just like that. For example, with this particular shape, I need this application. If you press this, the user has to redirect to that particular page. Just like that, the user, whatever the user want, whoever the user come to that particular developer, he will set to the software developer. Based upon his requirements itself, he will design. After interaction itself, what are the functional requirements? We have already discussed about the functional and non-functional requirements. What are the functional requirements we need? Next, we have to check the configuration of the, based on the configuration. If the software configuration is high, in the previous class I have discussed, if the software configuration is high, it is very difficult to run in the particular platform. Why? Because based upon the configuration itself, we will run that particular software in the platform. Okay? First of all, you have to check whether the particular configuration is correct or not. See, if we take the Facebook Messenger as a web application, what are the requirements they have made? First of all, he need one platform to run. Okay. The next one is, he need one camera to make a video call with a particular other user. The next one is, he we need another speaker to talk with the person. Just like these are the requirements. Whatever the user need, that is a requirement. Yes or no? Whatever we need, we can say that particular thing as a requirement. In that particular application, we can say that Messenger as a web application. For that web application, the main things they have to need is, first one is speaker, next one is camera, and next one is internet connection. Without the connection itself, the two users cannot interact with each other. Okay? The next one, in this designing phase, you have to check whether the interface is properly working or not. The next one is this aesthetic or not. It is content based or not. The next one is if we have to navigate that particular software based upon the architecture and based upon the architecture and component, we are going to design that particular software. The next one is in the construction phase. The construction phase is the main phase. The two phases are the main phases. Okay, all the phases are the main phases, but the main two phases are designing and construction. After designing itself, based upon the design, we are going to perform coding to that particular software. Okay, in this construction phase, the integration, we are performing the integration, and next one is select. After performing the integration, we are going to see based, we are having different types of modules. This is module 1 and this is module 2. Just like we are having some modules, okay, some lines of course, we are dividing it into the modules. After dividing it into the modules, we are combined tag and we will perform testing. Just like that, the process will repeat until that application will reach the user requirement. We will perform the iterations just like this. See, after we will perform the deployment. See, when we can say that particular product is ready for deployment, see, if a particular software product is ready for deployment, web application is ready for deployment, then we can say it is ready for deployment if it reaches the requirements of the user. From the beginning itself, what the user will do? The user will come to the software developer and he will communicate with the developer and he will explain that particular, he will need the requirements, he will explain the his needs and he will come back to user. After that the software developer work will begin. What now the software developer, what he will do? He will check communication phase is over. Next, planning. The software developer will plan what are the requirements need to this particular software. Next, whenever he has to schedule that particular project, whenever I have to schedule this particular project, and he has to negotiate the useless requirements and he has to elect the useful requirements. That planning phase is over. Next one is communication planning. Modeling means by looking at the model itself, if the model is good, by looking at the model itself, the user can easily interact with that particular application. Yes or no? If the model is not good, no other user cannot interact with that particular software. By the modeling itself, the particular user can interact with that. The modeling is the, in the modeling, what are the phases we are having? Analysis phase and design phase. You have to analyze it. You have to analyze that particular product. Okay, this particular product is good. We can do this. We can do like that. Okay. The next thing you need is analyzing the particular product and design. This by looking at the design, I have already said, by the designing, what we'll perform coding. After coding, by combining different modules, we'll perform testing. After, if the testing is successfully completed, what we will do, we will deploy the product to the particular customer. When we can deliver the product successfully to the customer, if it is running successfully, if that particular web application is running successfully on the platform, we can successfully deliver that product to the customer. This process will repeat again and again. So we will perform this iteration so many times. This process will repeat again and again until it will need the requirements of the user. Now let us see the differences between the normal application and web application. See, a normal application, if it is a normal application, we cannot, it is not, without using the internet itself, it can run on the particular platform. But if it is a web application, it is very hard to run. Why? Because without data, it can't run. Okay? Without internet connection, it won't be successfully run on a particular platform. Okay? So we have already said to you, if you want to send message to a particular, if you want to make a video call to a particular friend, we need one application. What is the web application today? In today's life, are sending messages to your friends, you are giving so many text messages, and you are sending multimedia messages, you are sending videos, you are sending whatever the thing you, what are the multimedia, all the multimedia files you are sending, all the text messages you are sending, all the emojis you are sending, you are making video call and you are making audio call. With that particular messenger, you are having so many advantages, yes or no? But with that particular messenger itself, you are taking so many advantages. But without internet connection, it won't be run successfully. Okay? It won't run successfully on the platform. By using that is the, if it is normal application, without internet connection itself, but when it comes to web application is very easy to design. Normal application is somewhat difficult to design. The next application is, web application is run successfully on a platform, any platform, the web application is run successfully. And normal application is will take some process. Web application has so much craze in the society. Why? Because through the internet, but normal application, so many people want, nowadays, so many people not trying to take it in a normal application. But when it comes to the web application, so many people are trying to take that web application. From the beginning itself, we are having what are the, first of all, we have to learn what is the software. From the software, what is the software? We can say we are taking some lines of code to develop an application. We can say that is the software. Then what is the software engineering? The process we are following, we can say that as engineering. Okay? The next one is, the thing we are going to do is, the next one is the software. By using this software engineering process, what are the applications we are going to develop? That thing also we have learned. Okay? The next one is, in this web application designing, what are the key features that you have to keep it on mind? What are the things that you have to keep it on mind? That also we have learned. Okay? What are the phases? In the normal, well, in normal application design also we are having these phases. What are these phases? Communication, planning, modeling, construction and deployment. In the web application design also we are having these phases. Communication, planning, modeling, construction and deployment. These are the different phases we are having. But when it comes to normal application, we don't follow all these phases. We follow some simple steps. But when it comes to web application, we follow all these steps. Okay? Then what are the major differences between web application and normal application? If it is a web application, without internet itself, without using internet, we can't run that particular application. If it is a normal application, by using the internet itself, we can run. Okay? See, these are the major differences that we have, that I have found. Software system efficiency. If it is a software application. See, normal application and web application. If it is a software and it is a web application, these are the differences that we have. System. It is small user base. This is wide user range. See, this small, this application, okay, user will use that application, but when it comes to web application, small number of users will use, but when it comes to the web application, wide number of users will use. This one is easy to, hard to develop. This one is easy to develop. This one is hard to develop and this one is easy to develop. The next one is both running platform very successfully. This can run the platform successfully and this one running the platform successfully. The next one is it will take long time to develop and it will take less time to develop. Okay? See, these are the major applications that we have learned. See, we know these applications that will add up. Okay? The first one is, if it is a small user brain, then it will use a wide user brain. Okay, this application also will use it by the user, but if it is a small user brain, then this is a wide user brain. It is very hard to develop and this is very easy to develop. And this, we can run this application in a platform very easily. And we can run this application in a platform very easily. This one will take long time. Okay? Why? Because see, it will have different modules. By combining these modules, it will take long time to develop. It is very long, it will take long time to develop and it will take very less time to develop. This is about web engineering process model. See, in the next class we are going to learn what are the testing strategies that we are going to, software testing strategies that we are going to apply. We are having so many types of testing strategies out there. Now in the next class we are going to